So welcome to Learn by Choice. So in this video, we are going to talk about the digital money lending applications. So recently, Reserve Bank of India has come out with a press release or also maybe awareness exercise, cautioning the people, the individuals and also small business about the way the predatory loan lending apps are operating in the country and how do they operate and what measures a borrower or maybe a prospective borrower can do to avoid falling in the debt trap through these lending applications. So let us discuss one by one. So basically the lending apps, as per RBI, so RBI permits this kind of lending practices. But the lending apps are the mode through which an NBFC or a bank can lend to the needy borrowers in an easy way. But it is not that without tying up with a bank or an NBFC, the lending applications can operate in the country. The NBFC and Reserve Bank of India are regulated and so that the lending apps also are indirectly regulated. Rules of RBI is also equally applicable for these lending apps. Basically, if you are taking a loan from a bank or NBFC, signing a loan agreement stating the terms of the loan and also the repayment terms and also the amount of loan, quantum of loan, what you are getting at the what rate of interest. So these lending apps which are operating in the country beyond the rules of Reserve Bank of India without tying up with either NBFC or a bank, so they operate there on their own terms without following these rules. So they lend the amount up to 50,000 rupees in most of the cases, charge higher rate and also they charge higher processing fee more than what is defined by Reserve Bank of India. While downloading this mobile application, they promise you the quicker dispersal of loan, but there won't be any proper loan agreement. And in the mobile application, they also don't disclose with which bank or NBFC they have tied up. So what do they do is they are basically money lenders. So they are providing loan to the needy borrowers by charging predatory rate of interest. In case the loan is not repaid, these mobile application, they follow the not the rules or the pleasant way of recovering the loans, and they don't follow the fair practices code defined by Reserve Bank of India. So for any lending institutions, not only giving loan but also recovery, the measures have to be as per the RBI rules. It's not that if the loan is not coming, you can adopt any rules. So the unacceptable recovery methods, the higher processing fee, not following the guidelines issued by Reserve Bank of India on fair practices code. In addition to that, at the time of downloading the mobile application, they get access from the mobile owner or the prospective borrower to access the photographs or gallery and also the other contact details. So in case the loan is not coming, they try to call the other people also so that the naming and shaming also happening. Legal notices in case the loan is not repaid on time, and also the fake FIR also being generated and issued to threaten the borrowers to repay the loan. Another method adopted by these applications, I call it rogue lending apps, is the snowballing of debt. If you borrower who has taken loan from these lending applications which are illegal, and they, in case the loan is not repaid, they try to create a provide loan through other lending applications so that the borrowers are continuously in debt. There won't be any grievance redressal mechanism. If you want to lodge a grievances, any lending apps, they have to follow the rules, either the RBI or the respective state governments. The charging high rate of interest is already banned in India. Court also can intervene, and they passed a rule, the Tusurius Loan Act in the year 1918, through which you cannot charge a loan beyond certain rate of interest. So Google also, the Play Store also played its part. Illegal lending apps which are available in the Play Store of Google, they have removed that. If a lending app or any app to be available for the smartphone users through the Play Store, they have to follow the rules or they have to accept the policy defined by Google. So one of the policy of Google is that the lending apps should follow the rule of Reserve Bank of India or the country where these lending apps are going to operate. Andhra alone, there are more than 280 apps are being removed. So you should not fall prey to these applications. If you find any apps are being still available, then you can lodge a complaint with the Reserve Bank of India, or you can lodge a complaint with the police or any law enforcement agency.